The root cause of evil is here, guys, your kitchen. The origin of evil is in your kitchen, guys. This is an, as I have been saying in my last videos, this cannot come from a human brain, because this is self-killing, you know. This kitchen, which I will call as a incredibly thought of advanced alien technology or something, because human beings are inconceivable of thinking something like a kitchen, because this is the origin of evil, guys. This is everything. This is, I think, where the term came, cooking evil, you know. And if you have a kitchen, and I'm sure if you are listening to this video, you will, you must 100% have a kitchen in your home. You should shut it down immediately and never step foot in this most evil place on earth. And also, especially women, I will make a separate video on it, why women should never cook food on earth, because it is not their duty to do so, you know. This I am taking as an example, but this is the most crucial thing, because this is where the destruction begins. When you cook in the morning with love, you give to your children your food. This is the most diabolical thing, because as we know, like, cooking destroys most of the nutrients. So when you steam it, you know, like, this is like only some amount of nutrient is destroyed. When you pressure cook it, they are showing it, you know, blue micronutrients lost in the cooking water, green micronutrients retained, red destroyed micronutrients. So boiled, when you boil your food, see, half of the nutrients is already gone. When you microwave it, most of us in conspiracy truth movement already know you should never ever microwave your food. That is, at least you should do that. But I would suggest, once you go through this video, I hope that you will consider this, because it is not easy, but we will take their own science-based facts and proof to prove that why cooking is the most evil thing. So cooking destroys any form of steaming, pressure cooking, boiling and microwave. This all happen in the kitchen, and it completely destroys your gut. They are attacking our gut, because gut, as I showed in my few last videos, it is the stargate, it is the wormhole. They can totally free us. That is where the magic happens. It's like the engine of our body, where everything happens, literally, you know. So this is the symbol of our own death, guys, kitchen and cooking. So I will go through their own propaganda piece, because they always have something to sell us, you know. So that is the reason they are creating, and this is their Wikipedia. Is, we know, it's totally propaganda, but I have other sources. But if I tell that, we are there, then many of the mainstream people will try to debunk it by saying that you don't have much reference and you are not science based. It's not science based. So we already know why large intestine. This is how we, our appendix is already dead, guys. That now the next is our large intestine. Through cooking, when you cook food, your large intestine dies, guys. This is the large intestine is where the entire magic happens. The one organ that is the key to humanity's freedom is large intestine. So as you are aware of what large intestine is already, so I won't go through it, but I want to, you know, take some pieces of it, what actually happens in large intestine. So you already know that large intestine, appendix is attached to the large intestine, and you should never remove appendix, because there, that is where the immune system, lot of immunity lies in the appendix. So I will, I want to like, you know, refer to one sentence where it is very important that you should know. In the four tissue sections shown here, so this is the part of large intestine. In the four tissue sections shown here, many of the intestinal glands have cells with a mitochondrial DNA mutation in the CCOI gene and appear mostly white. As you can see, guys, your large intestine is directly connected to your mitochondrial DNA, which is where you will get the answers. Who am I, where I am from, and where I am going. Mitochondrial DNA is the place where, when you go to know your root, your ancestry, the where you really from, they take the part of mitochondrial DNA, and it is directly connected to your large intestine, you know. It is where most of the, in school, you might have read how nutrients are absorbed in large intestine, etc. So I won't go through it, but this is what the most important part, you know. Why large intestine is important? Because large intestine is where the digestion of dietary fibers, starch, etc. takes place, you know. And why, this dietary fiber goes to your large intestine, what it actually does. This is what it does, guys. The bacteria break down some of the fiber for their own nourishment and create acetate, propionate and butyrate as the waste product. This is the key. We have been fed with for 100 years like carbohydrate, fat, nutrients and vitamins. Time to let go of that, guys. We need a part two of our life. So as we can see, fiber goes to the large intestine and produces these three short chain fatty acids. As I have been saying in my past videos, how important short chain fatty acids are, and gut flora, how important bacteria that live in your large intestine can really change everything that we know. We know vitamins are all scam, but they are saying that these bacteria also produce large amount of vitamins. So you can see even their vitamins and vitamin K is produced in the large intestine. Everything is produced in either large or small intestine. And then I will come. They always tell you that fiber and starch and resistance are. Starch is, you can say, it's a form of kind of a fiber which they never tell you to take, you know. And whatever fiber we have like starch, it is all processed foods, and processed foods, they themselves say they destroy the nutrients. So they like most people never take supplementary starch based food. So you already know what starch is. This starch is a polymeric carbohydrate consisting of large number of glucose units joined by glycosidic bonds. It is most common carbohydrate in human diets and is contained in large amount of staple food as potatoes, wheat, maize, rice and cassava. So I will just read through, because I have to cover a lot of things, but because I have already covered a lot of topic, but I want to this is the like food, you know, why you should have a lot of raw foods that I have been saying, and why cooking destroys this starch, guys. Fiber and starch is completely destroyed. Historically, people consumed large amounts of uncooked and unprocessed starch containing plants, which contained high amounts of resistant starch. Microbes within the large intestine fermented the starch, produced short chain fatty acids, which were used as energy as well as maintenance and growth of the microbes. As food became more processed, they were easily digested and released more glucose in the small intestine. Less starch reached the large intestine and more energy was absorbed by the human body. This shift in energy delivery may be one of the contributing factors to the development of metabolic disorders of modern life, including obesity and diabetes. You keep this in mind, short chain fatty acid and butyric acid. Your large intestine, through fermentation of starch fiber, produces large intestine. And when you cook food, you know, this is destroyed. You are unable to produce short chain fatty acid, guys. Everything, the key is fat. The debate, unending debate they are going on, is fat good for you or not? That is just a scam. It's a psyop. Fat is the key, as I have said in many, many videos. And fat is what drives adenosine triphosphate, not Bitcoin. I want to have a versus debate with anyone who comes out winner. Adenosine triphosphate is a nucleotide and is a small molecule used in cells as a coenzyme. It is often referred to as the molecular unit of currency for intracellular energy transfer. Without short chain fatty acid, you won't even be able to see this video properly, you know. This is the reason you are able to talk and walk and listen to this video, do your daily thing, because adenosine triphosphate is the energy transfer, you know. It is called the molecular unit of currency. Do you prefer this or do you prefer Bitcoin? And this is produced by in the large intestine. They have totally killed our large intestine through this one, guys, cooking. You know, if we had uncooked food, we have lot of short chain fatty acids, butyric acid. Once we have lot of butyric acid, we will have unending amount of energy. We are lacking energy, you know. That is, I will just go through more information why gastrointestinal tract is the key and why cooking food completely destroys. Our gut is dying. They are killing the large intestine now. Humanity is dying. I can even say, looking at our own gut, guys, we are eating cooked food. It guarantees our destruction. And GI tract is responsible for the entire hormones. Entire 100% hormones is created in your gut, guys. Immune system, entire immune system is created in your gut. I have shown in many, many videos why entire dopamine, serotonin, everything is created in your gut, you know. And short chain fatty acid is the key. I will read few more. How important this, as you can see, immune system, homeostasis is nothing but balance of everything, the way you are, you know, there is no excess of anything. But this is very, very crucial. You would not know this because it's very hidden in plain sight kind of thingy. Beneficial bacteria also contribute to the gastrointestinal system homeostasis. A case in point is the relationship between human gut and Clostridia, one of the most predominant bacterial groups in the gastrointestinal tract. Clostridia play an important role influencing the dynamics of our immune system in the gut. Now is where the magic is, guys. It has been demonstrated that the intake of high fiber diet could be responsible for the induction of TREX cells. Now, what is this TREX cells? You will not know this because you have been propagandized by, you know, whey protein and vitamins. You will not know what TREX cells is. This is due to the production of short chain fatty acid during fermentation of plant derived nutrients such as butyrate. That's why I've been screaming why butyric acid is the king of everything. Now we will go to this, what this T cell is. You know, you might have heard a lot about T cell. Let's read about regulatory T cells called TREX. The regulatory T cells, formerly known as suppressor T cells, are a subpopulation of T cells which modulate the immune system, maintain tolerance to self-antigens, and prevent autoimmune disease. TREX are immunosuppressive and generally suppress or downregulate induction and proliferation of effector T cells. TREX expresses the biomarker CD4, you can forget, are derived to be from the same lineage as naive CD4 cell. Because T cells are express CD4 and CD25, TREX are very difficult to effectively design for effector CD4. You can, recent research has found that cytokine TGF is essential for TREX to differentiate from CD4s and is important for maintaining TREX homeostasis. Mouse models have suggested that modulation of TREX can treat autoimmune disease and cancer and can facilitate organ transplantation. As you can see, this directly is connected to your cancer cells or cancer growth in human body. Because once you have less short chain fatty acid, TREX cells is, your T cell count goes down, goes up, homeostasis is not maintained. That is why the implosion, explosion of cancer begins, guys. Recent immunotherapy research in studying how regulation of T cells could possibly be utilized in the treatment of cancer. You don't have to go this far. When you stop cooking, you will never have cancer, guys. I can guarantee you, no cancer, no heart attack, no, because they are saying it here itself. Gastrointestinal tract is where TREX cells are created. And this is why, due to the formation of short chain fatty acid, we are dying race, because we don't have short chain fatty acid because we are cooking food, you know. It is a master stroke, guys. It is written in our destiny that if the day we if we continue to eat cooked food, we are going to be finished. It's guaranteed process, you know. That is why they are so confident about their own, you know, ruling us. It is completely related to cancer and everything. This is there, they explain more about this, and they are also telling about this TREX cell by enhancing histone H3 acetylation. You won't know this, what this is. It promotes histone H3 acetylation, but once you read this, what this histone H3 acetylation is, it is histone H3 acetylation and H3K4 methylation define distinct chromatin region permitting for transgene expression. So it opens your genes itself. You know, your gut flora literally opens your genes. But this is, I am just taking information from here and there because I am trying to connect their dot, taking information from there on, you know. Propaganda books so that they can sell you something. Fermentable fibers are consumed by the microbiota within the large intestine. mildly increasing fecal bulk and producing short chain fatty acids as byproduct. As we can see, short chain fatty acids is produced in the large intestine, which is everything, guys. When you cook your food, you don't have this fiber in your body. That is why we are getting sick, we are dying, you know. This fermentation impacts the expression of many genes within the large intestine, mitochondrial DNA they are talking about, which impact digestive function and lipid and glucose metabolism, as well as immune system, inflammation and more. Your immune system is directly connected to your large intestine, guys. When you cook your food, this fiber is very, very, very important to humanity. Everything is related to fiber. You should eat raw food, you know. Raw food is the key. Resistant starch, this is incredibly important. Some type of resistant starch are fermented by the large intestinal microbiota, conferring benefits to human health through production of short chain fatty acid. They will always tell you how bad acid and fat is. They are giving you all BS, you know, increased bacterial mass and promotion of butyrate producing bacteria. As dietary fiber, resistant starch is very, very key for our survival itself. Fatty acid metabolism, this is a very important, I will read it through so that you will understand. Fatty acid metabolism consists of catabolic process that generate energy and anabolic process that create biologically important molecules. Without this, we won't even survive. Fatty acids are a family of molecules classified within the lipid micronutrient class. One role of fatty acid in animal metabolism is energy production, captured in the form of adenosine triphosphate. As I said in many of my videos, this is ATP is directly related to our the mitochondrial DNA. This is the currency of our body, ATP, you know. If you want more ATP, like mining in Bitcoin, you eat more fiber, guys. You become a 100 trillionaire in the body term, you know. When compared to other macronutrient classes, fatty acid yield the most ATP. On an energy per gram basis, it is not proteins, vitamins, carbohydrates, whey protein, you know, juicing. Please never juice. Fatty acid yield the most ATP on an energy per gram basis, where they are completely oxidized to CO2 and water by bioxidation and citric acid cycle. Fatty acids, mainly in the form of triglycerides, are therefore the foremost storage of form of fuels in most animals. As you can see, they are themselves telling us how important, fatty acid. But still, I will go through more why you need more coconut oil, how magic coconut oil is, you know, because it's a fat, saturated fat, you know. Highest number of coconut oil works magically in you because it has the highest number of acids, you know. All these short chain and medium, it has medium chain fatty acid, but still it's incredible. Never take homogenated fats or trans fat, etc. They are all factory produced by these evil masters of our. Take natural food, eat raw food, you know. As a gut flora, the relationship between some gut flora and humans is not merely commensal, but rather a mutualistic relationship. Some human gut microorganisms benefit the most by fermenting dietary fiber into short chain fatty acid, such as acetic acid and butyric acid, which are then absorbed by the host. This is the most important line you will ever hear in your life, guys. I can guarantee you, the systematic importance of SCFAs and other compounds they produce are like hormones, and the gut flora itself appears to function as an endocrine organ. The thing that they told about pineal gland, what is pineal gland? That is just a secretion organ that's useless. If you don't have short chain fatty acid, pineal gland will not do anything. That is why it gets calcified, because your body is unable to produce short chain fatty acid. Because our dietary fiber, our large intestine is dying, you know. We are cooking food. That is why, please lock down your kitchen immediately, you know. Now I will tell 23, read this 23 before in my videos, 23 science-based health benefits of butyrate and its derivatives. This guy has written hundreds of, you know, articles on butyric acid. Sorry, butyrate is a molecule that is called short chain fatty acid. Fatty acids are the building blocks of fats, and our cells cannot be without them. Even our brain needs it. The reason humanity is becoming drug addict, people are dying from drug, is due to shortage of fatty acids and butyric acid, you know. Butyrate production is determined by the level of bacteria that produce butyrate and the pH of large intestine. If you are cooking food, your large intestine is as good as dead. Now I will see how what incredible butyrate is. You know, butyric acid is crucial for your gut health. Butyrate increases gene activity. This is where what the game is all about. You see, butyric acid is influenced with genes are active. Our 90% of junk DNA can be opened through butyric acid. They themselves are telling. Butyrate fights inflammation. Butyrate is good for the brain and nerve cells. Butyrate is used for treating anxiety, depression and mania. It's obvious. Butyrate is both a cure and enemy of addiction. Butyrate has anti-cancer property. Butyrate can help with weight loss. Butyrate may be good for balancing blood sugar. Treat allergies, autism. Useful in Alzheimer's. Butyrate is good for your mitochondria. That is why when you go for your ancestry, it fires up your mitochondria. We need to fire up your mitochondrial DNA to know our past, present and future. The reason they are able to rule us is because we don't know who we are, you know. We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow because our mitochondrial DNA is not open, you know. There are hundreds of uses, guy. Butyrate may increase red blood cell. Butyrate can kill certain type bacteria directly. Butyrate may increase dopamine. There are hundreds of the uses of butyric acid, short chain fatty acid. This is very important that you have non-cooked food. Shut down your kitchen. That is very, very important. Our large intestine is dying. I don't think humanity has much time. I am very sorry to be sound negative, but this is the fact, you know. We need more fiber-rich food, more raw food. Stop cooking food that will literally killing us, you know. Since last 40, even I am the same victim, but now slowly, because it's not possible right now to completely shut down because of my family structure. But within this month, I will be completely going raw food, you know. I am completely changing myself. I really hope that you do research and know what your body is, you know, and please look into a fiber rich diet and butyric acid, how important it is for humanity's survival itself. Yeah, guys, thanks.